And welcome into the Y'all Show, Talk with a Southern Accent. I'm John Rawl, and I am holding right here in my hand something that everybody needs to pick up. It's called Traveling Man, and it is Watermelon Slim's latest effort. It's not quite out yet, but it's coming soon, and this is a great blues roots music CD. It's a double CD. It's a live CD. It's going to be awesome. We encourage you to get it, but maybe if you're on the fence and you need to know a little bit more about it and more about Watermelon Slim, well, we're going to go right to the source. Joining right now on the Y'all Show is Watermelon Slim. Hello, welcome into the Y'all Show, sir.
John Rawl with the Southern Rawl on the Y'all Show. I love it.
That's what we do here.
Good morning.
Hello, and welcome into the show. You're getting ready, I think, to leave our beloved Southland and head to another part of the world.
That's true. I was just talking with the people in Paris. I am doing a benefit for an organization called 8 Hours for the Victims of Agent Orange. Now, I'll start by saying I'm a Vietnam vet. I was oversprayed by American chemicals, and I am lucky enough not to have suffered from that. But I am in, I'm going to be in Paris doing a show, as I say, called Oui, c'est pour les victimes de la Jeune Orange, 8 Hours for the Victims of Agent Orange. Specifically for a woman who is being sued against Dow Chemical Corporation, the manufacturer of the 2,4-5 trichlorophenoxyacetic acid that contains the dioxin that has caused so many deaths and birth defects and everything else since we faced it in Vietnam.
Watermelon Slim, let me tell you, and let all of us thank you for your service and so many of the great Americans that served in Vietnam in the 1960s and 1970s, many thousands of which did not make it home. What years were you there in Southeast Asia?
I went over on August the 30th, 1969. I came back I was discharged May the 22nd. And of course, I left Vietnam that same day due to the dateline change, May 22nd, 1970.
Okay.
I did almost nothing in Vietnam. My part was pitiful and small. I was a man who put equipment, mostly signal equipment, I was in First Signal Brigade, on trucks going to places where more was happening. But I did, in one of my handful of patrols, watch the plane come over. I've never seen a jet plane fly so slow and so low. And the plume of chemicals come out of the back of the plane. Here I'm 20 years old, and I see this plane doing this stuff. And within seconds, I felt the mist on my body, on my face, on my shoulders. I was only wearing a flak jacket, and when we were out on this perimeter sweep, and thinking back on it, of course, I know I was breathing it. So I know I was just lucky.
Yeah.
To have survived that with no physical effect to myself. My daughter, who lives in Atlanta, has decided with her husband she probably won't make a child because it's risk.
Man. What branch of service were you in, Watermelon Slim?
I was in the United States Army. I volunteered for it. All our family has always volunteered for it. My father volunteered for it twice. He was first, before the United States would enter the World War II, he was a member of the, an officer in the British Navy. He went risking a 5-year in prison sentence and $25,000 fine. In 1941, he went and joined the Royal Navy. Now, why did he do that? Because he'd already been in Nazi Germany in 1938 as the guest of Hitler's personal secretary, Christian Stengler, a Harvard man in the beginning of the 20th century. We've always fought the fascists. It's generational for me. I'll fight them today. And that's another story.
Well, you went, of course, to Vietnam, but prior to serving in the Army and heading overseas, you grew up part of your life. You were born, we won't hold this against you, Watermelon Slim. You were born in Boston, but you got as south as fast as you could. And you claim North Carolina is sort of the state that you grew up in.
I do indeed. Yes, sir. Asheville, North Carolina, which was basically at that point when I came there at the age of three when my parents divorced. It was a big hick town in the western end of the state. There was culture there, but the most exciting things that my mother and her second husband ever took me to were tobacco auctions. To hear the real classic thing, you've heard how you may have only heard it in a recording. How tobacco auctioneers did their thing, and it was to actually have known that, to actually have heard Flat Scruggs in their prime live, to actually have sung Big John with Jimmy Dean. You know, I was a Southern man, and I'm the only one in my family.
And going back to the early days, since we're about at the 100-year mark of this happening, it was Asheville, North Carolina.
I will tell you this. Let me tell you this. I went to Daytona. They just had the Daytona race. I went to Daytona and drove there. I was at least 10 years before the fellow who was conducting us on our tour at Daytona International Speedway. I watched my first stock car race in 1957. Before there was even a Daytona track. So that's how deeply involved. I first heard the blues in 1954 in North Carolina. That's how Southern I am.
Man. Well, I was going to say Asheville, North Carolina is also the spot where Jimmy Rogers was living around 1920 or so when he got the, I guess, notice that they were going to be doing those recording sessions in Bristol, Tennessee, and he went up to Bristol and changed music forever with his sort of roots music.
You from around Bristol?
No, I just know a little bit about Bristol and Western North Carolina, too. I try to be kind of all up on the South, and I'm not doing a very good job at it.
There you go. I go through Bristol whenever I'm headed north or south, you know, whichever way I'm going. That's where you get on, basically close to where you get on 81 going north.
Right.
I'm a truck driver. I have driven all 48 continental states and every province that abuts the United States. I've never driven in Alaska or Hawaii. I stopped in Hawaii on the way to Nam and and in Alaska on the way back. But I've been in 50 states, technically, anyway.
Okay. Well, we're glad that you are very well-traveled because you're using that experience with your music. This latest effort is Traveling Man. It's from Watermelon Slim, and he is our special guest right now here on the Y'all Show. This is coming out here in a couple of weeks. Want to make sure you do it. This is now your, I think, 10th record on your current record label. And you've been, when did you actually start making music professionally, Watermelon Slim?
Well, the very first record I ever made, hoping to be professional, and produced in that way, was 1973. I made a record called Merry Air Brakes. I actually had bought a bus, a school bus, a hippie bus, that belonged to a friend of Ken Kesey's who I met 30-some years later and partied with him, too. But this the first record was made with this name. I was negotiating in the summer of 1973 with Atlantic Records, with Adrian Barber, the producer of Eat a Peach and Wheels of Fire, the iconic Cream record, just gigantic producer that used to work for Ahmet Ardagan. And that fall happened to be the year of the OPEC oil embargo. So suddenly the price of oil was 400% what it was 3 months ago, and suddenly Atlantic Records was not interested in producing this record by a young Vietnam vet without a proper commercially successful pedigree. I never made another record for another 27 years.
And that's when you started driving trucks?
I was not even driving truck at that point. I was still a forklift operator and a grunt laborer.
Okay.
I spent a lot of my life as a grunt laborer.
I like your style. I don't know where you get your hats, but whoever gets you set up on that, they're doing a good job.
In fact, I am a hat consultant in Clarksdale, Mississippi, to Floyd Sankerman of Sankerman's Menswear, the oldest continuously operating retail business in Clarksdale. I'm proud to give him a plug. His grandfather started the business in 1925, and he's still running it today.
And is it right there in downtown Clarksdale?
It's across the street from the Bluesberry Cafe, the restaurant and cafe that I'm a minor partner in since I've been here in Clarksdale. I've been here 11 years.
Oh,
well, not quite 11 years. I'm in my 11th year living in Mississippi.
Okay.
I've always lived somewhere in the South, you know, except for a time I did spend in Yankee Land.
Uh-huh.
I went from North Carolina to Oklahoma to back in 2009 after the real estate bubble busted, you know. I said, well, where am I going to actually own the first house of my life? I guess I'm going back to Mississippi. And the whole story of me being in Mississippi is another whole story I can't go into because we haven't got time. I was mugged and robbed and left for dead in Mississippi in 1999. I came back in 2005, played there, knew I always would come back, and 4 years later bought myself a house there for a price I couldn't have afforded a bathroom up north.
Well, Mississippi.
I live in Mississippi partly because I can.
The Delta where you are, Cahoma County, is a place that, let's be honest, it's had its better days. It's a place where a lot of people have left. It's only about 50 miles from there to Memphis, so a lot of people have moved closer to the Memphis suburbs, but it's been a rough part of Mississippi because a lot of industry has left Clarksdale and Cahoma County, but a lot of people go there for people like Watermelon Slim, who we're talking to here on the Y'all Show, because they love the music. They've got the Juke Joint Festival there each year. I assume you are a big part of that.
In fact, we have in Clarksdale, which is the county seat of Cahoma County, we have actually lost something around 20% of our population between the 1980 census and today. So there is a steady drain of population. There's not a lot of money here. We have two things that keep Cahoma County around, and that's farming, and that's pretty static. The people, there's no great attrition in the people that are doing agricultural business around here, and tourism, and that's the part that, as the minor partner in a restaurant here, that has the blues as part of our program, as the main part of our program. I know what it is down here, that the place never got up so high, so it's never going down so low. But we depend upon tourism, upon international booze tourism here in Clarksdale for the bulk of people's money who aren't actually making it due to directly or indirectly to farming.
Mm-hmm. Well, I know, as a guy who spent many, many years about two counties away from Clarksdale, Mississippi, how many tourists, especially from across the pond, come to places like Clarksdale, Mississippi, and spend a lot of money and a lot of time going to these juke joints, going to see places like Morgan Freeman's place there in Clarksdale, and I guess your place too now.
Well, our place, the Bluesberry Cafe's been open. Arturo and Carol Cravaro came from Miami and opened the Bluesberry in 2004, no, 5. I met them almost as soon as I came back to Clarksdale after having left in 1999, been thrown out of a town with multiple compound jaw fractures and a concussion, and forced to drive to Oklahoma.
Where did that happen to you? Where were you mugged? What town was
that? I know what it is. I know what it is to be told, don't be seen here after sundown.
What town was that in?
Clarksdale.
Oh, it happened in Clarksdale. Okay.
Oh yeah, it happened 200 yards from my restaurant.
And you came back.
Oh yes, I knew that I would. I had come to Clarksdale to apply for a job. This is all in two different songs on two different records I've made. Okay. Big Shoe Spill and Okeechobee Blues. The first song was called Shed My Blood in Mississippi. And I was mugged and robbed and left for dead in the parking lot. And then the police threw me out of town after the hospital had not treated me for what turned out to be multiple compound jaw fractures and a concussion.
Good Lord.
Oh, I was beaten almost to death with a blunt object and robbed.
Well,
but I came back. I knew that I wanted to have ought to do with the place, you know. After a while, I got my master's degree, but I was back in the truck immediately because people didn't want me as a school teacher with no teeth.
Well, you're back at it.
I'll say this: it's very important if you're going to do a middle class job, a job of brain work, you have to look like you've been in the middle class. And after I've lived my life, I don't look like that at all. I look like I've got more scar than face. It's all right. I don't mind now. You know, I'm not going to go back.
Right. But you got a pretty face, right?
Big what? Big this. I talked 3 days ago to a class of high school seniors from Champaign, Urbana, Illinois, people being brought down here under the auspices of the University of Illinois. I had a ball doing it. I actually wrote about an entire college essay to provide the notes for my presentation. But I know that there's no way in the world Watermelon Slim is ever going to be asked to put on a suit and tie and teach kids anything. You got to be able to smile to affirm the students that they're doing the right thing, and I can never smile anymore.
Well, we're hope you're a smile.
Oh, it looks like a smile, you know. Yeah. I turn the ends of my mouth up, but it's not a smile. You got to have teeth, and I can't ever have any teeth again.
Well, Well, hopefully you're smiling a lot about the new Northern Blues CD that's out, Traveling Man, and it's awesome.
It's a great story. I come down, it's made in two different places in Oklahoma. The Blue Door, where it will be released on the 27th of March. That's in Oklahoma City. That's on McKinley Street. And I want you all to come down there. I urge you to buy your tickets early because it will be full.
Okay.
And then the other place was down in Norman, under the Norman, Oklahoma, is south of Okie City, and it was part of the Winter Wind series, which I hope to also play for people again live. I look forward to all this stuff. I hurt. I'm not going to tell you I don't hurt, but I can still jump off the stage. I can't jump back on it as quick. and I promise everybody when I can't do it 100%, and I still can. When I can't do it, I will not make the mistake B.B. King made of going on until he had these. Sitting in his chair and couldn't do the whole thing. God bless B.B. King. I love that man. But it was sad that he felt it necessary to not take time off for himself at the end of his life.
Well, Watermelon Slim, we can't thank you enough for coming on the Y'all Show and telling us about Traveling Man. Again, this is coming out March 27th, so a few weeks to go ahead and get your pre-orders in and check him out when you're presenting this in Oklahoma in a couple of weeks.